Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're doing this review a bit different today. I am using my new Zoom audio recorder today, and we're just gonna see how this goes. This might be what I'm doing for college for a little bit instead of doing, you know, getting all of my camera equipment. So we're gonna see how this goes and might go along with it or might just switch the camera. We'll see. This is gonna be a non-spoiler review, and the clips that I'll be playing in the background will not correspond with what I'm talking about to make sure this does not get spoiled for you guys. Also, remember to leave a like or this video is gonna end. To start off, the DCEU has had a rough run. Once I heard that James Gunn was going to be doing a new Suicide Squad, I was on board. And the question is, did he deliver? Yeah, this should come as no surprise, but James Gunn knows exactly what he's doing. And this time around, he doesn't have the studio down his back messing with everything. We all know David Ayer's cut. He has gone on record that he has his own cut of the 2016 Suicide Squad, and I still don't think it would be good.
What was that? I should kill everyone and escape? Sorry. The voices. I'm kidding. That's not what they really said.
That being said, it does suck that he doesn't have his own cut, and the studio was changing things left and right, but the studio has learned their lesson, not only with David Ayer, but also with Zack Snyder, and they also always know that James Gunn will always deliver like usual. In my opinion, this is the closest the DCEU is going to get to their own Guardians of the Galaxy. This movie overall, it's cute, it's fun, and it's very, very gory, it's very, very rated R, which works for this cast and for this story. It's hard to pick a favorite character from this movie because it is jam-packed full of DCC and D-list characters. Even though they're all terrible people, you do learn to grow with them and learn to like them along the way. King Shark and Ratcatcher 2 are the heart of this movie. These are the characters that really pulled to me the most. They pull you in on the sweeter side of the squad. Another standout character is Polka Dot Man. He was definitely one of my favorites growing up as a kid, and I really like what they do with him in this movie. Other characters I really enjoyed was Idris Elba's Bloodsport and John Cena's Peacemaker. All these characters I just mentioned are new faces to the DCU, and I think they do a really great job. For Bloodsport and Peacemaker, I really like how the two bounced off each other throughout this whole movie. They have like this competition to see who's the better marksman, and I think it was done really well in this movie. I really enjoyed it, and it really kept me hooked in. The returning members are Rick Flag, Harley Quinn, and Captain Boomerang, and this movie actually gives Rick Flag a character, and I genuinely really cared about him in this movie. Margot Robbie returns as Harley Quinn as always and is good, but I do have to say the first half of this movie, I didn't find her funny or even compelling. I've noticed the three movies that she has been in, the writers struggle a little bit when it comes to writing her, but her performance is always decent and really solid. Harley Quinn in the first half of this movie is, I don't know, I just found her a bit awkward, and there was something about it, I just didn't find her funny at all, and I think she just works so much better when she's bouncing off of other characters. And for the first half, she isn't really bouncing with too many people, but then when she's around other characters, I think she does an absolutely great job. The action in this is great and over the top. It's exactly what I wanted from this movie. It's gruesome, and it's actually a bit more gruesome than I thought in some parts. And again, I loved it. It was just super fun, and I think it works best when there's humor involved in this super gory, over the top action. It just really works, and I really liked it in this movie. I had a great time watching this really fun action movie. Since this is non-spoilers, I will say there is a villain in this movie, and if you haven't seen the trailers, don't, because it's just so good. If you want to know nothing, I'm going to go and give you a time code to skip to. While I'm doing that, let me just give you a couple seconds to skip to that. But if you're staying, if you've seen the movie, I'm going to go and talk about it right now. I wish they never revealed it in the trailers, only in the movie, but Starro appears. Oh my goodness, it is so amazing to finally see Starro the Conqueror on the screen. Starro is a very hokey and dumb supervillain from, you know, like the old DC comics, and he's the first villain the Justice League fight against. He's just a giant starfish, and he's crazy, interdimensional, and he throws little tiny starfish and they mind control you and stuff. It's just so kooky and fun. I always liked Starro as a kid, and I always thought Starro was a little creepy, you know? There's something about a giant starfish with many starfish minions that mind control you. It's a little creepy as a kid, and they even bring a little bit of that creepiness to it, and I really, really dug in this movie. I think they did a fantastic job with Starro. Again, this is non-spoiler, so I'm not going to say too much, but the only complaint is I wanted a little bit more. I wanted them to go just a little further with it, but overall, I loved Starro. I hope they do more with him in the future, and it's just so nice to say that I finally saw him on screen and they didn't, you know, screw it up. So yeah, that was nice. If you thought I wasn't gonna have Rick in this video, you're surely mistaken. He's coming up right now. We're gonna go cut to him real quick. Oh my goodness, what a smooth transition, Chase. All right, guys, we are over here with Rick. What's up, Rick?
Hey, what's going on?
All right, so we're gonna kind of go over some thoughts with him and see how he thought of the movie. So what did you think overall?
Overall, I thought it was an excellent movie. I was really impressed with it overall. It was great. Made me forget all about number one.
Yeah, number one's not good at all. We all know that, though. It's nothing different. Did you think any of the humor landed, or most of the humor landed?
Yeah, there's funny and jokes all throughout, but none of that led me left saying, yeah. So yeah, I think the whole thing worked very well. Very hilarious.
I think for me, some of the jokes at the start with Harley Quinn just didn't really land. I don't remember anyone in the theater laughing at them, from my memory at least, so I think those are the ones I don't remember.
Yeah, myself, I mean, I chuckled throughout, and laugh out loud, so I enjoyed it overall.
Yeah, there's some great humor, and I think the ones that really stood out are the gruesome ones, the deal with the action or deal with the violence. I think those are the ones that really stand out. There's a really good joke of Peacemaker in his underwear.
Yeah, that was hilarious.
I like that. It's just in your face. Like, right. Yeah, I really like that one. Next question. What did you think on how some of the characters were handled? Meaning their interpretation like King Shark or their interpretation of the C, D, and E and F list of characters. What did you think on how they were handled?
No, I think everything was great. I know, like I said, Shark is usually a beat buff dude and just muscle all over, but he was kind of a overweight, flubber guy, but overall, I mean, I liked all the characters. Don't think they could have, in my mind, changed anything or made anything better. I really liked their direction on them.
Yeah, in The Flash, he's usually this giant buff dude, but in this one, he's more of a kind of a dopey, dumb kind of shark, and also, I guess it's more close, not really, but it's a little closer to the Harley Quinn animated series.
Well, we put the profile up and we're not getting any bites.
Is that a shark joke?
If so, it's very funny.
I think I've shown you the episode where he shows up.
Yes.
I think both of them are completely different interpretations, but they're just similar compared to what we're known as King Shark. Ratcatcher 2 is a nobody character, but I really liked her in this movie. I think her characterization I think it's really done in this movie. Harley Quinn is Margot Robbie's Harley Quinn is always the same, is always really good. She does a really good performance. I think Idris Elba as Bloodsport was a good standout as well. I really liked his character. What did you think about the villain?
Pleasantly surprised and excited. I didn't know what to expect. Yeah, I was happy with it.
Yeah, I was really happy with this villain. I wish we saw more. And I wish they didn't show in the trailers, because after if you've seen all the trailers, there's really not much left to surprise you with, which is fine, you get the jokes and stuff, but as a reveal, I had like a little tear in my eye just seeing that finally on screen. It was so nice. Also kind of creepy as well.
Right.
If you had to pick one standout character, who would that standout character be for you?
It's hard to say. It's a tie between Peacemaker and Bloodsport, really.
Okay.
I love them both. I thought they're excellent.
For me, it's like a tie between King Shark and Ratcatcher 2. Not only because they were the heart and soul of this movie, really. They're like the kind people in this movie, they're the ones that's really looking for friendship amongst these terrible, terrible people. So I think that for me, if I had to pick one, I don't know, I'm a big King Shark fan, and I just really liked what they did with him in this movie, so I'm gonna go with King Shark.
Exactly.
Without spoiling, what did you think of some of these deaths?
I mean, I knew some people were going to die, Suicide Squad. I was very upset that a couple that did, but thank God all of them were handled. Most of them were handled very well, but I think it's hard to say without spoiling it, but couple or...
Some are unexpected.
Unexpected, definitely. And
there's some characters I'm like, oh, that character's going to be dead the entire... No,
yeah, the whole movie, nope. Yeah, exactly. So,
yeah.
Left me a little jaw dropped. Like, what?
And in a good shock value way. They didn't do it just like, oh, we're just going to kill a bunch of characters just to show you. It's like, no, it was there to show, like, they're not messing around, and they do it in a really, really good way.
Strategic.
Yeah, some characters, I thought they were going to last the whole movie. So that really shocked me. So any last thoughts on the movie?
I thought it was an excellent movie. They did a great job. Once James Gunn got a hold of it, I figured it was going to be pretty excellent.
Yeah.
Cross between Guardians of the Galaxy and Deadpool. And it was fun, gruesome, awesome action. And just the other movie was just putrid. So it was like, I'm so glad that they got a great story, great director, and they knocked it out of the park.
It's hard to say where this ranks on my DCEU movie list. It's definitely top three or top two.
Yeah, top three. I'm going back and forth between. It's not number one, but it's two or three. It's going back and forth. I have to really think about it. Maybe I have to watch it a second time to solidify a spot. But overall, I mean, I have to give it a 9 out of 10.
You give it a 9? Yeah. I definitely want to watch this again. And now it's on HBO Max, so we can watch it free.
I mean, technically it's not free because you're really paying for the subscription.
Yeah, I pay for the subscription.
But yeah, I mean, like, you know, I think it's really rewatchable. I think it's really fun to watch. I'm going to have to go with an 8 or an 8.5. Yeah, okay, my final verdict's going to be an 8.5. I thought there was some stuff in this movie that could have done a little bit better, mainly with Harley Quinn. But overall, I really like this movie. I really loved it. I always put all my faith in James Gunn. He always delivers, so he never does wrong.
And
always
James Gunn, we trust.
Yes, we always trust in James Gunn.
Yeah, like I said, stick with the hard 9. There's things ticky-tack we can always look back on, but... just overall, it was a great time. You know, great to be back in the theater again as well and enjoying a real kick-ass movie.
Yeah. All right. Thanks for talking.
Thanks. See you guys.
Ah, what a guy. So yeah, my final verdict for this movie, like I said, it's going to be an 8.5 out of 10. I think the only reason it doesn't get a 9 is some of the jokes don't really land in the first half. But like I said, this movie's really funny and genuinely hilarious at some points. I just think, you know, some of the jokes could have landed a little bit better, and some of the stuff with Harley Quinn just could have been written a bit better, since this is her third movie. But I watched it in the theater, and if you're not able to, it is on HBO Max, and it's free on HBO Max. I mean, technically it's not free, because you're actually paying for it. Shut up. It's on HBO Max, you can watch it for free, or go see the movie, but I understand the times we are in, you might not be able to do that. I just really recommend people to go see this. I had so much fun with this. I hope they get James Gunn back for more movies after the Guardians trilogy. I really like his tone that he has set for the Suicide Squad movie. And maybe he could do his own little trilogy or even do other superheroes or even villains. I would be totally on board with that. Anywho, thank you all for watching. Remember to leave a like. It always goes a long way. And make sure to subscribe and tell somebody. Tell a friend. Tell a mate. It just goes a long way. Anywho, I'll catch you guys later after I move back into college. See ya.